Chad Wojtek, Pitt Panthers, just tell me, in the most intangible sense, how much fun this is to be the guy. You know, I mean, I've been watching you here for a long time now, and there's always been someone else at the helm.
Right. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I mean, playing football is fun, and whenever you get a lot of reps, it's fun. You know, I get to play the game that I love, and I get to do it with some of my friends. So, I mean, that's just the best part of it, and we're all getting better and working together, so it's been fun so far.
Now, your style is going to be different than Tommy's. I mean, he's a typical drop back. I don't want to say typical. He's good. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Drop back NFL-style quarterback. How will yours be when you're on top of your game?
You know, I think a nice mix. I think I want to be a pocket passer. I want to win games from the pocket, but I also want to have the ability to escape and make plays when they break down. You know, when plays break down, I want to be able to get out of the pocket and make some throws on the run. So I'm excited for that, too.
I see a lot of rollouts here, too. That's going to be a big thing for you?
I think so. You know, he's put some more in. He's added some more sprint out plays for us. And me and Trey have similar styles, so it's been good.
Now, that guy, Tyler Boyd, it's funny that he just goes by and photo bombs here, because he was my next question for you. How important is it, how incumbent is it on you as quarterback to get the football to that guy?
I mean, that's key.
Every team, I don't mean to interrupt, you know every opponent is going to scheme to stop you from doing that.
Right. You know, I think Coach has made a point of it. Whenever he's double-teamed in the red zone, still throw it. I think Tyler's a player that whenever they have him covered, he's not really covered. So we're trying to find throws to him, and I have guys around me that I can spread the ball to as well. I think that's the key thing. Like, we have athletes here, just get the ball in their hands.
Well, let's talk about some of those, because Manessa Garner is a guy that a lot of people are looking to step up. Adonis Jennings is a talented guy, a big-time recruit that was brought in here. How many other options do you have out there from the receiving standpoint?
Oh, I mean, like you said, those names, and then guys like Ron Jones, Kevin Witherspoon. I mean, just it goes on and on. And I feel like any of those guys can step in and make plays for me. And I have a great running back as well, a great running back core with James and Isaac and those guys. And so it's fun. It's easy for me. It makes my life easier just to get the ball in their hands and let them get the yards.
Chad, being Pitt quarterback can be tough. I mean, you saw when Tino was here, he had a really rough ride.
Yeah.
How are you prepared for that? Because you have to be prepared for it mentally. It's one of the tougher jobs in Pittsburgh, I think.
Yeah, it's a tough town to be the quarterback. I agree. I've definitely got to see. I mean, even Tom caught some stuff, and then, you know, he gets drafted, and everyone starts to like him a
little
bit more.
He's awesome all of a sudden. I noticed that.
He got really popular all of a sudden when he was on the draft boards. But, you know, I try not to pay too much attention to it. I'm sure I'm going to catch something. I'm going to throw my first pick, and I'm going to get some heat, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, take all things in stride, and if I throw that pick, as long as we win the game, you know. And I think just keep my eye on our goals, and don't let the outside buzz, as you will, bring us down as a team.
And I have two more questions for you. One of those is that I keep hearing that you're not actually 6'2", but yet I'm 6'2", and you're not in heels or anything here. So where does that come from? Is it because you play quick?
Well, you talking about my height?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I'm definitely not 6'2". I don't know what sources you
got
that
from.
I 6 foot. I'll take 6 foot.
All right.
6'1". I'm listed 6'1" in the book.
Okay.
So we'll say that.
We'll say 6'1".
6'1". 6'1" on a good day, we'll say. And you know, it's always been a chip on my shoulder kind of thing, and it's always been my negative. My downside is, he has a great arm. He can throw on the run. He's fast, but he's 6 foot.
Can't see over the line.
Right.
Yeah.
And
you got a big line, too, this
right,
year.
Right. I have a big line, but, I mean, it hasn't been a problem so far.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I can't see it becoming a problem. And you just got to move in the pocket and find holes, find throwing lanes, and just use your feet to make plays.
Last question that I have for you, Chad, is a lot of the players that I've spoken to here speak with almost like this passionate tone about restoring this program. I mean, 5-6, 6-5 isn't going to cut it, obviously. It's not going to take the program to the next level. What will?
I think taking each day, I think we've done it so far. I think each day, know what you're working towards, have a goal in mind for that day and for the future, and do everything that you can to obtain that goal and to just cling to each other. Like you said earlier, you know, there's going to be people and media and all that kind of thing, things that are going to bring us down. But if we cling together, I think that's how you build a program whenever you have a strong core and a strong leadership core to shut all that out.